Today we'll discuss about JEE Mains 2016 paper, Physics. Hello students, let us start a new paper, 2016 Physics paper, JEE Mains. We'll start with the question number 1. The question number 1 says, a student measures the time period of 100 oscillations of a simple pendulum for 4 times. For 4 times, the data set is this and this and this. So, in 4 readings, he has got for 90 seconds, 91 seconds, 95 seconds, and 92 seconds. If the minimum division in the measuring clock is 1 second, then the reported mean time should be. So, any reporting time, any expression or measurement is done in terms of some mean value plus minus the error involved. This is how you write the reading. The reading is mean value plus minus error. Mean, you can call it true value. We also call it accurate value. And these values are measured values. The measured values are 90 seconds, 91 seconds, 95 seconds, and 92 seconds. There are 4 readings, 1, 2, 3, and 4. 4 times. Now, the instrument in which it is measuring is a clock of which can measure not less than 1 second. So, minimum you can measure is 1 second. Just like a normal watch, 1 second can measure. So, therefore, when the oscillation is taking place, any when it completes, suppose 100 oscillations, I suppose say that is 1 oscillation. If it completes 1 oscillation, stop it. So, while you stop it, it doesn't necessarily measure the actual time of oscillation. It might be a little less than that, because when the pendulum comes to the extreme starting point again, so when you stop the watch, it doesn't necessarily stop at the time when the bob is there. It might be little late or it might be little early. It might be exact, but we don't know. So, there must be some error introduced when you stop the watch, when the oscillations are made. So, therefore, we always write the reading in terms of the exact value that you can calculate plus minus error. You have to introduce also error in the measurement of these oscillations. So, this is how you write this. And how it solve? So first, this is a true value or accurate value. If the discrete data are given, you have to take the mean. So we'll take the mean of this first, that is a true value or mean value. So the mean of this x mean is, there are 4 readings, x1, x2, x3, x4 divided by 4. That is 90 seconds plus 91, 95, 91, 95, and 92 seconds divided by 4. That you have to solve. And how to solve this? You can see that this I can from 5 here, I'll keep 2 there. I'll keep 2 there, and out the remaining 3, I'll put 1 here and 2 here. So, this will become 92 if I give 2 to this and 1 to this and take 3 from here, minus 3. So, that minus 3 is distributed 1 and 2 over there. So, this will become 92 and this will also become 92 and this will also become 92 and this is already 92 divided by 4. So, this is 92. This way you can save your time. Otherwise, you can add up and divide by 4. then also it will be 92. So this 92 seconds, we suppose that this is the exact value of the oscillation or mean value or true value, and with this there is introduction of error. So the mean error, you have to write the absolute error is defined as the mod of the difference between the x mean and x individual. There are four readings, so xm minus x1, then we will have next absolute error xm minus x2 and so on. So if I write xm minus x1, it comes out to be 92 minus the first reading was 90, so it is 2. The second absolute error, this is say delta x1, I will call this a delta x1, and the next reading this is delta x2, which is xm minus x2, which is 92 minus this reading is 91, so it is 1. Then is x, delta x3, in the third observations the error introduced is xm minus x3, which is 92 minus 95, which is 3, and the last one is xm minus x4, which is 92 minus 92, that is 0. So these are the absolute errors you are getting, and we will take the mean of these absolute errors, individual errors that we got from the individual observations. So what we'll do, we'll find the mean of absolute errors, that is delta x mean is equal to delta x1 plus delta x2 plus delta x3 plus delta x4 divided by 4. This is we got individually 2, 1, 3 and 0 divided by 4. This is 4 and 6, 6 by 4, which is 3 by 2 is 1.5. So this the reading is x mean plus minus delta x mean. That means I should write x mean I got 92 plus minus 1.5, but then we cannot write like this 1.5 because the least count is 1 second. So in whole number you write, in whole number means as you can see in options these are not possible, this fraction is not possible. You will take less than you can take 1 here or you can take 2 here because it is 5, and if I round off this, round off, then this would be even because it is odd, because 5 is still dropped because I have 1 second, so I should have 1 digit and not 2 digits. So in that basis I have to drop this. If I drop this, then this has to be increased by 1. If that increases by 1, then this is plus minus 2. Okay, seconds. If you see the options, then the option number 1, you can see, is 92 plus minus 2 seconds. This is the right answer. So, what you have to do, the rule for this, in some solve like this, some solves like they go for this options, some go for this option, but I don't go for this option because I have 1 second, so I'll have 1 digit, not 2 digits. So in that basis this is the answer, and the rule for this round off is that if a number dropped to be is 5, if the number that is to be dropped is 5, then you see if any other number is present. Suppose I have 1.501 or 1.52, or whether I have 1.45 And so if you have a number, if anything is present here, then you increase the previous by 1. If the number dropped is no digits are there, but the number dropped is 5, then make it even. So it is 2. Then also it is 2. If it is 2.5, then it should be 2. Because it is already even, you don't have to increase this. So this way you have to solve. So the option 1 is correct option. Okay. Thank you.